Good evening, friendarinos. Welcome to the happiest day of your life. Or at the very least, a very special one. You should be excited, because these don't come very often, and as it turns out, they always come with a price. To my sanity, that is. Today I'm gonna show you the top 10 grinding spots for experience, and the top 10 grinding spots for skill points. The updated ranking for all of the grinding areas. If you remember the old project done in a similar fashion, it's basically that, but the updated version. Now, for this one, there is a catch. You see, I'm not quite crazy, at least not that crazy. So the idea was, I looked at my old spreadsheet and I just simply picked the top 10 areas that ranked the best for experience and the top 10 ones for skill points, and I only retested those. We don't have any simulated numbers, any predictions, whatever for today. It's straight up retested from the ground up, but it's only gonna be about 20-ish areas, the relevant ones. Whatever is not included in today's spreadsheets, just simply remember they are not worth it, they are not in the top 10 or anywhere close to it, it's just simply not worth looking at. That being said, sit back, relax, and let's enjoy this very insightful conversation. And I'm gonna warn you now, skip ahead at your own risk. I'm gonna start explaining the stuff you need to understand the spreadsheets. If you go straight there and say later, but I cannot achieve the same clearing speeds, oh my god, boohoo, how are you grinding this fast and how are you getting these numbers? Well, that's your own fault at that point. So here's the stuff you need to know. First, but funny enough, not the most important one, this is the class I used for every single area tested. Corsair Succession with 290-ish AP. That includes the Valencia areas, the one-shotables, including Sulfur Mines and Pilaku Jail, which for me are one-shotables, but also the high-end ones. And I wanted to stress the point that this is experience testing and not money per hour. My main goal going into this project was to try to squeeze as much experience as I can from the areas, which means I physically tried to grind as fast as my class allows me. For areas like Valencia, I legit cannot grind any faster. I believe the experience is more or less capped, because the only way to grind any faster is to pick a different class that physically moves faster from pack to pack. On the other hand, you have the high-end areas where there's obviously room for improvement. If I had more AP, I could grind those slightly faster. Does it make sense so far? Okay, pets, loot, trash. Trash per hour is gonna be more or less the only metric you're gonna have for my clearing speed to some extent, but remember that pets need time to loot from the ground, and if I am just zooming through all of the Valencia regions and one-shotables, my trash per hour will be below what you normally should expect. It's not gonna be like the money per hour videos, it will be lower because my pets legit struggled to pick from the ground. On the high-end areas, it is somewhat representative, but for example, Elvia, the say Bloody Monastery, if I have an Elvia weapon, I'm still leaving behind a lot of trash, so do remember that. Other than that, everything was tested on a yellow loot scroll, that's the baseline for a trash you're gonna see, just remember, level 2 loot scroll, and Marnie stones, yeah, more like the lack of Marnie stones. I forgot those existed, like always. Let's just say I remembered halfway through the project, so no Marnie stones, no monsters killed per hour this time. And lastly, for those interested to replicate the results, we cannot really have a ranking without consistency. These are the buffs that I used in terms of experience and skill points for all of the areas. If you're wondering why those numbers specifically, just because my older charts work on those numbers as well, so just so I can compare them to each other. So, at this point, we should be on the same page. I hope I didn't bore you too much, but hey, it was a necessary evil. Now we can take a look at the ranking and the spreadsheets and the happy conclusion. Wouldn't it be funny now if I started doing the number 10 and then number 9 for every single area, for experience only, and then move into skill points, number 10 and then number 9 all the way up to number 1, being a real YouTuber, sad, but now this is today's conclusion, the spreadsheet for experience ranked from best to worst and at the exact same chart but ordered for skill points. This is legit what you came here for. The details I just spent like 3 minutes talking about, the gear used, and yeah. Number 1, best area, Gyphins, then second one, Bloody Monastery, third one, Orcs, kind of to be expected, Biragi, fourth area, if you are expecting anything else. Thornwood, 5th, Sicraia or Star's End as number 6. For your information, I only tested Sicraia. I didn't get a rotation empty for Star's End. Let's just say, I know from past experience these two areas are almost identical, so I just, you know, Star's End is the same as Sicraia. Number 7, Elvia Fogans. Number 8, Elvia Nagas, because Nagas are dumb and they just don't wanna scale with Elvia weapons. You just don't get any real extra speed. Number 9, Castle Ruins, the fast run. The original test is this one with 15,000 trash, but I simulated, you know, scaled up to 18,000 because I did the outside rotation and I know 17 to 18,000 is doable at Castle Ruins, so that's my result. And the last one worth mentioning, Sicraia upper level, the lower requirement, Sicraia. If you look a bit down through the other areas, I also visited the Morrowax Labyrinth from the Winter region, and somewhere here is also the other one, Jade Forest. They are not exactly great for experience. At the very least, I went there for future proofing, but they are not top 10, to say the least. And lastly, if you look at these numbers, you might be a bit confused. Gyphins, 10,000 trash, that's just the trash result. Bloody Monastery means 10 minutes Elvia weapon, B4, 4 bells popped. Biragi, the number, again 13 minutes on Elvia weapon. Orcs, 29 minutes on Elvia weapon, that's what the number means. The minutes used on Elvia weapons. And you also might have noticed the multiple entries to Gyphins. This one, the Gyphins 10,000, is what I expect most people to get. The Gyphins solo is my original test at 9,300 trash per hour. Gyphins duo was an interesting attempt where I chose a friend, a Shy. Don't think it matters the class, but we attempted to grind in a party the exact same tower, both of us. Very interesting, not quite recommendable. It is a lot faster and a lot safer to grind it that way, but the experience result is not quite worth it. Around 6,000 trash per hour is what we were able to get with the loot being split between both of us. Then you have the Gyphins 2 towers, where we both grinded 2 different towers, still in the same party, but each of us was grinding a tower of his own. Oh my god!
I just looked at the plates and I just saw 100, 250, 220.
Yep. Corsair life in a nutshell. In this case, I guess this one was on Corsair with 8,400 trash for myself and 10,100 trash for my partner. This is a clearing speed. Then the exact same method attempted again, but on my wizard, because I can actually do Gyphins properly on the wizard. 9,500 trash and 9,500 trash with essentially just a bit better experience, and Gyphins 11,000, just the same as this one. Simulated 11,000 trash because maybe some people can actually grind it at this speed. For the skill points story, the first thing I will point out is that this number looks atrociously low, and it's mostly because my Corsair is soft capped for skill points. Like, she got to a point where she barely gets anything. Most of you will get maybe like 7-8 times more. Again, the number is completely irrelevant, but just know that it looks this low just because I'm soft capped on skill points. The best area seems to be Polyforest. For whatever reason, it used to be on par with Sulfur Mines, but now, retesting it, I looked at the numbers multiple times to make sure I didn't do anything wrong, but maybe it got buffed at some point. It is faster, somewhat faster, maybe 20%, 15% faster than Sulfur Mines. Regardless, it is the absolute best choice. Sulfur Mines, what I would recommend, second best. Gyphins at around 10,000 trash, the third best, or I guess the second one if you can grind it at 11,000 trash per hour. Kadri's, the fourth one, then Crescents, Fogans, Bashims, Blood Wolves, Pilacogel, and Nagas. This is the ranking. This is Valencia Nagas. So this is your situation for skill points. It's funny how originally when I went into this project, I did it mostly just so I can update the charts to make sure that everything is correct, but I was expecting different results. I knew Gryphins is the best, I kind of expected Polyphorus and Sulfur to be at the same level, but I low-key expected to see some buffs to some other areas. You know, I took breaks from BDO for months and I didn't look at all of the patch notes. I kind of thought that the ranking would look a bit different than it did 1 year ago, but turns out the biggest surprise of today was just simply Gryphins is broken and hopefully it doesn't get nerfed. Looking forward to Elvia Kalfion. Yeah, I'm looking forward to those. I will add them to the spreadsheet eventually, so I guess check the link in the description. But yeah, let's end today's video on a good note. For those of you who made it all the way here, since this is a special occasion, a big project, we have a code! Oh wow, surprising, isn't it? The Duo Big EXP project code, which will give you some experience scrolls to help you, you know, level up faster. Am I not a very nice person? It will expire on May 4th, so make sure to redeem it before then. I believe it only works for EU and NA. By the way, like the video or I'm gonna come haunt you in your dreams. It was a nice day, I'm tired, I'm gonna go take a break, hope you enjoyed it, I will see you next time, thank you to all of the members, because I always forget to thank them, I appreciate all of you, your continued support, and I will see you with some other less stressful projects. Bye bye.